Connect the tongue to the palate. Inhale slowly, exhale slowly. Let us pray to the Supreme God, Divine Father, Divine Mother. We thank you for your priceless blessings, for divine light, divine love, divine guidance, divine love, mercy, inner healing, physical healing. Thank you for the inner strength to practice regularly. Thank you for your divine help and protection, for illumination, for abundance and prosperity. We thank you. Let's be aware that today we are going to be discussing the angel hierarchy. This is going to be part two. So we are going to be discussing the middle order of angels. But before that, we'll do the beautiful archangel meditation recorded by Acharya Nona. And we'll take it from there. Okay. Okay. So we have the seraphims, and the seraphims basically are, there are seraphims, there are cherubims, and there are thrones. And then after that, we have what's called the middle order, which is also called the middle dominion. The middle dominion of angels are called dominions, virtues, and powers. The third order of angels, which is also called the lowest order of angels, these are principalities. These are principalities, archangels, and holy angels. So this is what we discussed on the first day. Now today we are going to, so again, this is the highest order of angels, the seraphim, the cherubim, and the thrones. The next order is the dominions, the virtues, and the powers. And the lowest order is the principalities, the archangels, and the angels. So on your book, The Ancient Science and Art of Pranic Healing is the picture of a healing angel. So we talked about this last time. Today we are going to talk about the dominions. The dominions are what is called the middle layer. Now the dominions basically regulate the work of the lower angels. It is very rare that they actually incarnate. But if they do, then they look like very, very beautiful human beings, and they have a pair of what is called feathered wings. The other important thing in how we identify them is that if you have seen a scepter, so there's this picture of a scepter out here. So a scepter is something that you may have seen in the pictures of kings. It is also held by angels. It is held by this particular category of angels. And on top of the scepter, there is an orb. So orb basically has a, the orb is a ball of light which sits on top of the scepter. And if you're dealing with an angel who is also a protector angel, then they have a sword. And on top of the sword, which is called a pommel. Pommel is where you hold the sword, okay? So in that part, you have another orb of light. So this basically is a way of identifying the angel that we are working with. Okay. So like it says here, there are orbs fastened to their scepters or to the pommel of their swords. Now, the next category is what's called the virtues. Okay, so the virtues are godlike energies. So those of us who have done pranic healing or Arhatic yoga, we know what virtues are and how much emphasis there is on the pranic, in the pranic healing school, on the virtues. So Master Cho has identified five virtues for us, right? So those are which ones? There's loving kindness, there's generosity, there's honesty, there's constancy, and there's moderation. Okay, so if you look in the top of the screen, it says virtues, or what are also called strongholds, are basically godlike energies. So these aspects of God, these five aspects of God, is what we want to learn through the school of pranic healing and also Arhatic yoga. So as early as basic pranic healing, if you look at the last chapter, Master has talked about these virtues. Those of you who have done practice sessions with me, mass healing practice sessions, as you remember, we have done a lot of healing using these virtues for people. So basically, the idea is that as we develop these virtues, it becomes more and more difficult for the vices to enter. So for example, if we are going to practice the virtues, then the opposite virtue becomes more difficult. So for example, this is another way to look at this is also called the golden rule. or in the Eastern sciences, it's also called the yin and yang. So it says that, you know, the yang has the seed of the yin and the yin has the seed of the yang. Okay, so the idea basically is that these are in constant motion. And, you know, if you've done Arhatic Yoga, you'll also know that Master actually very systematically helps us to understand what these virtues are and how they are to be practiced and how many levels they have, right? So in this context, what I have been talking about, this is a suggestion that came from my team, particularly from Kunal. He said, you know, let's do inner reflection. So in the process of what we call inner reflection, which is also given in your basic pranic healing book, and those of you who have not done pranic healing, you can just buy the book on Kindle. Okay, it's called The Ancient Science and Art of Pranic Healing by Master Chokok Sui. So what I was basically saying is that in the practice of the virtues, I have also read the Bhagavad Gita. Now in the Bhagavad Gita, what I realized is the first shloka, Dharma Kshetre Kurukshetre Samaveta Yuyutsavaha, Mama Kim Pandavascheva Kim Kurvata O Sanjayaha. This is what Dhritarashtra tells Sanjay. So obviously, right now I'm not going to explain this, but I have a couple of YouTubes out there on the Bhagavad Gita. And basically we're going to go through a whole series of inner reflection using the Bhagavad Gita as our text. So that was something that we will launch sometime in August, hopefully. But anyway, that's just FYI. If you want to develop your virtues. Now the question is, why do you want to develop your virtues? Because when we develop our virtues, it becomes easier for us to take decisions and to understand how to run our life. So why are we talking about this? Because in the middle order, so there's the highest order where we have the seraphims, the cherubims, then we have the dominions and the virtues, and then we have the archangels and the lower angels at the bottom. So the archangels are actually the middle order of the lowest order. I know it's a little bit confusing. I'm going to put up a chart at some point where you can understand where everybody is. Okay, so moving on from here. So there's also, you know, another category of angels, which are called the powers or the authorities. Now the powers or the authorities supervise the movement of, what does it say here, of the heavenly bodies. Now what are heavenly bodies? So the planets, the suns, the moons, the comets, the galaxy, all of these are heavenly bodies. So in case, again, this is again my favorite book, you know, The Existence of God is Self-Evident. In here, Master Chor says that basically when someone is meditating, at some time what they can see, instead of seeing the solar system, what they actually see is, you know, it says here, page 49 of this book, The Existence of God is Self-Evident by Master Chor Kok Sui. It says the planetary luminous flowers are actually double-sided. One luminous lotus flower is facing the top and the other one is facing the bottom, but the two of them are connected as one. So on page 47, he says, during the meditation, when the consciousness of the meditator expands just slightly, when he sees the solar systems, he does not see the planets revolving around the sun. He sees luminous lotus flowers up and down, rotating around the sun. So it is my understanding that this is probably the heavenly bodies that are supervised by the powers or by the category of angels that are called powers or authorities, and they are the middle kingdom of the angelic kingdom. Okay, now for some of them, they're also warriors. They're warriors in the sense that they oppose evil spirits. So as we know that there is the dark side and there is the light side, right? For those of us who are Star Wars fans, you understand what I'm talking about. So if you actually watch some of these movies like Star Wars, Doctor Strange, in fact, Kunal was also talking about doing a series on movies, but so maybe we'll do that at some point when we when we run out of ideas. But anyway, so that's one of the ideas we have. So anyway, going back. So these angels are usually represented as soldiers wearing a full armor and a helmet, and they also carry weapons. So what kind of weapons do they carry? They can carry swords, usually it's swords. But keep in mind, they can carry any kind of weapon because it depends on what they're trying to do, what they're trying to protect us from, and what their purpose is. So they also have shields, spears, they also have chains. Now you may ask, you know, what is an angel doing with us with a chain? An angel is probably going to help. So, you know, there are entities that use matter. There are entities that use matter properly, and there are entities that use matter in a negative way. So the powers or the authorities basically grab hold of the entities that are using matter in a negative way, and they actually chain them and they actually send them somewhere in the universe. So if you've heard of the word you know, hell, or for example, if you've heard of Hades, which is also called the, you know, the god of the netherworld. So perhaps, okay, perhaps these angels kind of put these entities into like a chain or a ball, or they tie them up and they send them somewhere to put them aside till they can be dealt with. Now, if you want to know what happens to them and how they are dealt with and how they evolve and how they eventually become God, because remember, Master also says God loves everyone, the good, the bad, the terrible, right? So obviously something has to happen with these entities. So to know that, you have to basically read the book called The Solar System by Arthur Powell. This is the book. It's called The Solar System by Arthur Powell, where you will understand the evolution of the human kingdom. Okay, and the devas. So again, that's not the scope of this particular episode. So we'll move on. Oops. So yeah, so what I wanted to say is all these pictures have come from free pics. That is what I was trying to say. So the last time we discussed the lowest order of angels, the principalities, the archangels and the angels. And today we have discussed the dominions, the virtues and the powers. So these are all the people who are not people, these are entities who are helping humanity evolve. And if you have paid any attention to what Acharya Nona said, she said basically that the angels are here, the angels are there to protect us. So you might be thinking, if they're here, why can't we see them? That's because the angels are very subtle and they don't usually take a body. So if you just go back to this, where it says here that the angels regulate the lower angels, and it's very rare that they take a physical form. So they don't need to take a physical form because they are what are called astral beings, and astral beings actually can move very fast. So sometimes if you're wondering, you know, if Archangel Michael is taking care of me and my family, then who's going to take care of my neighbor's family? Well, you have to be aware that Archangel Michael, firstly, he can move very fast. All the angels can move very fast because they move to what is called the astral body. Now, if you want to know what the astral body is, then there are seven layers of the something called planes. And I'm just going to give a short summary of that. So basically, there is the physical plane, which is what we can see, you know, physical matter. Then there's the emotional plane. Then there's the mental plane. Then there is the buddhic plane, the Atmic plane, the Anupadaka, and the Adi. So these are the seven planes. If you read any of the books on theosophy, you can learn more about these planes. Now, the angels operate on the astral plane. The astral plane is the emotional plane. It is where you call there is only light. Okay, so they operate on that particular plane, and that enables them to travel very fast and to, of course, take care of a lot of people at the same time. Okay. To the Supreme God, Divine Father, Divine Mother, we thank you for your priceless blessings. Thank you for the knowledge of the three orders of angels, the seraphims, the cherubims, the second order of angels, the dominions, the virtues, and the authorities, the third order of angels, the archangels, the guardian angels, the personal angels. We thank you for all these angels. Thank you for your presence. Also, please remember that the angels are energy beings and they are going to remain around us only when we are positive. If we are angry and upset, then we actually repel the angels. So if you really want the angels to stay, you have to figure out how to keep yourself in a happy frame of mind. Let's do the soul affirmation. So the soul affirmation basically says, I am not the body, I am not the emotions. The emotions and the thoughts are products of the soul. Okay. So basically, if we are creating a negative thought form, then we can also correct that negative thought form ourselves. Right. So just be aware of that and try to think of positive things about yourself. Try to think of positive things about the others around you. And that itself will help. That will allow the angels to remain with you, to guide us, and to help us grow. Okay? So that's what I had to say.